We have two gentlemen of the band right sitting here on this beautiful stage. We have Zodiac on the left and Slam on the right. Welcome.
Hello.
They're here because they will release very shortly a new album called The Tattooed Beat Messiah. Zodiac, Mind Rob and The Love Reactions, you already have been on MTV. Remember the slashing of the piano?
Yeah. Yeah, I remember that. Yeah.
Still, you can still see the bruises on it. Yeah. Anyway, can you explain me your names? They sound to me like cartoon characters.
Boy, I've never heard this question before. Yeah, we stole them from comics. I stole mine from a comic and I gave Slam his name because it sounds like he plays loud drums.
Which kind of comics do you like?
Filthy ones. I like really dirty, rude ones. The American ones. You can't buy them anymore, actually, because they've stopped making them. I like French ones as well, Marcel. I think French comics are really good, but I just can't read them. They're writing some strange language.
In which way are they rude, the ones you like? Are they rude by cutting up people or a lot of sex?
Oh, everything, just just the most sickest, vile things you can imagine by drug-induced psychopaths in America in the 60s. But they've all grown up now and become tattooists and got run over by buses in Korea.
The cartoons you're talking about are those underground cartoons.
Yeah, but I like other ones as well. I mean, I like Daredevil and Swamp Thing and Frank Miller and stuff. I don't know if you get that in Europe. Probably.
But surely not Tintin.
Yeah, Tintin. No, no, I find Tintin boring. I don't like Hercule. I hate Snowy, you know, kick the little dog.
But are you yourselves cartoon characters? Are there other persons behind these Zodiac Mind World persons and Slam?
Yes, we do exist in cartoon land, yes. Have you ever seen the film Twilight Zone? Yeah, well, we're from cartoon land. That's where we live, the fifth dimension.
Yes, like Cobalt, he's in fact, he has a degree in philosophy, which is completely something else.
Yeah, he's always lying about that one, yeah.
So that's not true then.
He just waves his Plato book around and doesn't
he? Carries his paperback Plato in his back pocket.
With the first page turned down.
Well, I think he actually has got one somewhere.
Is it?
He tells us, I mean, he tells us a lot of things, you know. We're often catching him out on his little porkies.
But is there a line for yourselves between reality and fantasy, or is it all reality? Are you like you are, or is this a fantasy for you?
I don't know. Maybe I could have answered that 2 years ago, but now I think so much water has gone under the bridge that I can't remember if this is real. Is this a real studio?
I think so. I don't know.
Are we in fact real, or is this just merely a product of my imagination? Well, that is what has been said in the past.
Okay, we will talk with Zodiac and Slam a little more later on, and we will hear a track from their new album, Tattooed Beat Messiah, Backseat because the good Lord told me last night in my sleep that Zodiac and Slam would be in the studio this Sunday afternoon. Gentlemen, you will be releasing your first real album, in fact, called The Tattooed Beat Messiah. I have here a little cassette with some extractions on it. It's quite good. Tell me all about
quite
it. This
good.
Is not a complete. This is not a complete album. It's got Prime Mover on it and a Backseat Education. Can you tell something about the other tracks, Tattooed Beat Messiah?
The other tracks, there's a lot of stuff with me just prattling away drunkenly, and they kind of left the microphone on, and if I will offer a prize to the person who can actually decipher what Zodiac actually means, a panel of judges will judge this, and the prize will be awarded if you can translate what I actually mean, because I sure as hell can't.
You have a lot of tattoos on your arm, I see.
Yes,
so you are the Tattooed Beat Messiah.
Yes, it's me, baby. I'm here to preach the word.
There's also a version of Born to be Wild on that. Why did you do that song?
To show the cult how to do it.
Isn't it quite risky? It's like a real rock anthem for years. Steppenwolf's version is a classic version. It's quite difficult to make a better one from a classic song like that.
Yeah, but we did it.
Just like that.
No, we got offered a lot of money to do it by some guy that's making a movie, and he just says, if I give you this money to go in the studio and do Born to be Wild, will you do it? And we had nothing else to do that week, so we said, sure.
So that will be in a movie also then?
Yeah.
I don't think it's very good. I don't know. I can't remember the title of it. Something about a lizard or something. Blue lizard, something like that. I don't know. It's also on Phonogram. It's a great film, you know.
The clip we're going to see, Backseat Education, has also this fantasy and reality thing in it. Japanese martial arts and sex or no sex, who will tell it? What is this clip about?
It's just how great we are and, you know, how tough we are. You know, we fight all these Chinese guys and it's all fake. They would have beaten the tar out of us in real life. I don't know, we've been in this, it's self-explanatory really, yeah. There's no hidden meanings in there, you know.
You don't go walking around with these things with chains in between.
Lord, no, no.
Oh my god.
It's just more juvenile fantasy, you know. Childish, puerile rubbish as usual.
Mm-hmm. Well, this is, for me, it was the teenage anthem of the year last year, Backseat Education. But you're not teenagers anymore.
Shut up, of course we are.
Eternal teenagers, yeah.
Eternal teenagers,
we're just
that's
mentally
nice.
Retarded, that's all.
Okay, here we go to see it, Backseat Education. I've got a backseat reputation, Zodiac Mind Warp and the Love Reaction.
I can't even drive.
You don't need to drive in the back seat. The wheel is in the front.
Freddy's dressing. Yeah, I love Freddy's dressing. It's wonderful, yeah.
Freddy's dressing.
It's pretty
great. Mm-hmm. No. Yes, go on.
No, we just like Queen a lot. I think they're... But that was Roger Taylor's band. That wasn't Queen.
No, that wasn't Queen. That was anyway, what are your favorite whatever bands? Hard rock, heavy metal, speed, trash?
Speed, trash. What do I like? What was the last cassette I got?
The last one I got was Aerosmith's album, which I think is a damn good album.
Mm-hmm. A damn fine album.
Damn fine album.
Fine damn album. The last one I got was Bruce Springsteen, believe it or not, Tunnel of Love. I like the way he looks so poor when he's a millionaire, you know?
Yeah.
It's wonderful. He's wearing his poor homeboy clothes, you know, I ain't got a buck in my pocket, man, singing these songs from my heart here.
You only get cassettes and albums, you never buy them.
Yeah, I buy them all, actually. I'd hate going in begging for records. I feel so low, mm-hmm. You know. So I buy them all. Besides, I like getting recognized in Virgin.
I always wondered what these guys would do when they're off duty. I mean, if you don't have to do interviews, don't have to be on a tour or playing a gig or be in rehearsals or being in the studio, what do you do then?
Vegetate.
Do you have hobbies? Do you knit or do you go and swim or something?
We drink lots of whiskey and stare at the ceiling, basically, you know, wait for somebody to come and plug us in again. Okay, come on, let's get you. It's the time for a show. Here we go.
Here we go. Bam.
Papers in boxes. We go in the store, in storage, in boxes in the wall, you know. And they wind us up every 6 months.
Yeah. Isn't it about time you do a major tour? I mean, now after the album?
In February.
Mm-hmm. Where will you go to?
Britain for 3 weeks in February, then over to the Europe in March, and then hopefully to the States.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
When will this album, Tattooed, Beat Messiah, when will this be out?
Don't you try and get me out of that show.
Little music. Like,
creeping in here, trying to get me out of the show. What are you doing?
Is there a new single coming up? Because I only could show the old ones, Prime Mover and Backseat Education.
Yeah,
probably Planet Girl. We wanted Let's Break the Law, but unfortunately it's all about getting sore on the floor, you know. And they don't like that for some reason. I don't know why. Mm.
But George Michael sometimes likes it.
Yeah,
he does it in his videos.
Bump and grind, but it's probably because he's a little bit cleaner than us, I think. And it's all kind of kissy-kissy, it's not this kind of stuff. Really.
Did you make some resolutions for the new year?
No.
No? Hoping to get into 89, I suppose?
Just hope that I make it to 89, that's all.
Okay, I hope so too.
So do I. Yeah.
This was Zodiac Mind Warp and Slam from Zodiac Mind Warp and the Love Reaction. This is Eminem's MTV Gig Guide, and this album will be out on February the...
22nd.
22nd, it's called Tattooed Beat Messiah. See you. Tomorrow. Oh yeah, see you tomorrow. I'm off.
It's
bye.
Monday, Marcel.
Yeah, it's Monday. Monday, yes. No, tonight. See you tonight at 1 o'clock. Oh, yes, I'm off now.